I just want to say a word before we start this video that this is not a tutorial. This is just my experience showing you what I went through doing this art. It's not as easy as they make it look on the advertisement, but it is a challenge. It's a long video. If you want to skip through some parts, be my guest, but I just wanted to cover as much as I could think of to cover with little instances and things that come up. So I hope you enjoy, and let's go. So welcome to my channel, Joy's Happy Hobbies, and I'm Joy. Nice to meet you. If you're new to the channel, I'm wishing you a welcome, and I hope you stick around and come back. Don't forget, if you're new, right underneath this video is the red square that says subscribe. Go ahead and click on that, and hit the bell, because once you subscribe, clicking that bell will let you know when I've posted new new videos. And also like. Hit the like button. Always like that. Anyway, I wanted to, and then I'm glad if you're a subscriber to me or you're one of my faithful viewers, I'm glad you're back. Anyway, let's get on. I want to wish everybody a happy Valentine's Day. I hope you are having a fantastic day with your Valentine and being treated like a prince or a queen. So I just thought it was a fitting day to introduce a new craft that I'm going to get into. And this is kind of like the design. We'll open it. It's paper filigree painting. Basically, it's paper quilling. I mean, that's how I saw it on internet and on other YouTube. So I went ahead and bought this one. Let's get it open and look at it. I haven't seen what it is yet. So let me get this tape undone. Okay. And we'll unroll this. All packaged up. I got this a week or so ago. Boy, really curly, huh? Okay, let's see what's in here. Okay, let's get it open. Oh, sorry, all the noise. Anyway, I started looking at a few of these videos on YouTube, and you know how we all got started on diamond. Okay, let me get this out of here, and then I'll talk. Jesus.
There we go.
Okay. I remember how a couple years ago when the pandemic hit, we were getting Facebook ads all over our Facebook. And now I'm getting these paper quilling ads on my Facebook. So I decided to check it out, just like I did with the diamond painting. I'll go over these things in a sec. I think I need to fold this like I do a... Okay, there's instruction sheets. Maybe I need to fold it back a little bit to get the curl out. All right, we'll take a look at this. Okay, and the reason why I said it was fitting, because it's basically a heart shape. It's a heart with flowers in it. So this is what it looks like. So that's why I'm opening it today for Valentine's Day. I wanted to have a heart to show. Yeah, that's what the painting is going to look like for the paper quilling. Okay. What does this say? It says, please confirm the color position according to the color number of the paper corresponding to the color of the reference picture before you have started the process. For the similar colors that are not easy to distinguish in this process, we've made a color distinction map. Please refer the directions. The EVA board, which I guess is this, may have creases during transportation, which is not a quality problem and can also be used after being flattened. Okay. So probably what's going to happen is I'm going to have to lay it flat like this for a while with some books on it. But anyway, let's take a look at it. So how this works. Now, I've seen videos where they actually take this stuff by hand and make it into designs. Don't think so. So when I saw this kit, these are actually little ridges. Let's see if I can get this closer and show you. Get a little closer up at it. There we go. These lines are actually ridges in there, and you're supposed to be able to set the paper in there. So I don't know how easy that's going to be. And let's look at this. Okay, we hope you enjoy your unique quilling experience. Even though we have taken every care dealing with your, we are only human, and although they are very rare, at the busiest of times, mistakes happen. And it's just saying that if you have any questions on this, then get a hold of them. At some point in our lives, we find that quilling is an amazing thing ever invented. But what if, apart from assembling, you enjoy seeing each piece in the shape of an animal, vibrant colors that come hand mentally and dexterity, relaxation, and family enjoyment? With this being said, we integrated the best supply chain. I don't think I need to read this. Feedback needed, affiliate program. Yeah. Okay. We're going to put that aside. All right. Here's the paper. Okay. So this has a color chart here on the paper that I'm going to use. Okay, I'm taking these out for the very first time, so I don't even know. I'm going to try to do this new craft. I will post videos of it when I get the hang of it. Okay, so we got our tweezers, and this is like some of the tweezers that I get in some of my diamond painting kits. From China. Yeah, so you know where this came from. Just from watching the videos, here is a needle, I guess, to poke the ribbon in. Okay. Yep, it's kind of sharp. All right, so we're going to put that back on there and cover that up. We've got a glue bottle with a cover on it, and it's kind of pointy, and I think those are what's gonna, you're gonna put the glue in here like so, in these ridges. The glue's gonna go in like that. You see? All right, and it's got a little stopper here so we don't leak glue. Hope you can see all this. I hope I'm getting it in the camera right. And now to put the glue thing back up on top here. Okay, so probably need my magnifying glasses for this. Well, I'll put that, I'll mess with that in a minute. Okay, and what's this? These are stickers. I guess maybe to keep the pad down while you're working on it so it doesn't move. Maybe that's it, huh? I don't see any other directions for it. But that maybe that's probably what it is for, to stick the mat down. Okay. And then here we have the paper. Paper filling. Now I'm not gonna open it yet because I don't want it to get all messed up. Well, maybe I can do a little bit of it here. It's going to be interesting. I've never done or seen anybody do this in real life. And here's the paper, as fine as it could be. Here's the paper. And it comes wrapped up. See that? Wrapped up. Okay, so you can see that. All right. Well, that's it. It doesn't really have any more directions to it, but this is the picture, like I said, and I'm going to try and do this for Happy Valentine's Day, because this is what we are now, but I'm going to try and get this started. Now, this shows all the pretty colors where everything's supposed to go, see? And we'll just have to try it. So this is going to be my new project, very new project. I hope I can, maybe when I get to start doing it and I have a couple in there, I'll do a demo on a video for you. And then we actually see how it works. So this is a piece of foam. Okay, get down. This is a piece of foam. I'm going to go ahead and put the camera back out here. There we go. So this is it. This is what it looks like. So there you go. Not much more to say about it because I really don't know any more about it. But there's supposed to be, I thought I was supposed to get some type of glue for this to, I'll have to read it and find out. I know it's a glue bottle from what I saw on the videos of it. But there's no glue in it now, so I'll have to look into this a little more and see what I have to do. So we'll be back on this one for sure, I promise you. And when I figure it out, we'll do a demo on my channel. Okay? So again, happy Valentine's Day to everyone, and we'll catch you on the next time around. Bye. Okay. I'm back. As you can see, it's quite a bit after Valentine's Day. That was my unboxing just before this, the day that I opened this paper filigree kit. And I've done a lot of research since then, and the following videos and fast forwards that you're going to see before this is my working on it. So it wasn't as simplified and as easy as all the advertising videos show. No, I could not get it done in a day, like they claim. So first thing I did after I opened the box is I went to the uniquill.com paper filigree site. And I watched, I didn't get this from Uniquill. I got it from some off-the-wall painting company that I saw advertised on Facebook. So I had to go to Uniquill. It was the only place that would show a tutorial. And the first thing I learned about the foam not wanting to lay straight was I had to buy a foam board, a straight foam board like this. Okay. And it's pretty straight, as you can see. Okay. And I cut it down to size, and I glue, and the instructions say, glue it onto the board, because even if you use double-sided tape, it would pop off the double-sided tape and still curl. So we did go ahead and glue it on the foam board, but as you see, it's still kind of curved after it was glued on. So I don't know how to make this board straight. So that was the result of gluing it, and we used Elmer's glue like they showed. So that was the first thing. I'm happy about that. And then what else? Oh, because I'm not a crafter, and I don't have crafting tools around, it was supposed to come with some pair of sharp scissors, but those weren't in the kit. And after watching that video tutorial, I ended up buying my own embroidery scissors. Okay, they're nice and sharp and pointy. So that was the first thing. Then it comes with a little tiny glue bottle, which I tried to use. I had to buy my own glue to fill it. Obviously, it didn't come with glue,
But it was so small, I couldn't really get a grip on it when I was putting it into the ridges, okay? So I went on Amazon and I bought a bigger bottle, but of course I had to buy a package of six, so I got lots of extra glue bottles, and it does have the point at the top to put into the laser cuts with a cover on it. I wanted to show you that these bottles that I bought off Amazon did come with the funnels, and I found out the funnel was very, very helpful. Okay. So the other thing I bought, she recommended on the video or the tutorial, this glue. It's called Neutral pH Adhesive. Whoops. And it's by Line Co. And it's fast drying and it dries clear. So I wanted to do everything that I saw in the tutorial to make this thing right. And the funnel does help. You put it, you know, it does help pouring this in. I just pour some in the funnel and let it drip through. And you have to fill this quite a bit of times, but it does help. Okay, I recommend using a funnel to fill your glue bottles. Okay, and then it did come with the tweezers and the awl. And both of these you use.
Awl.
Awl. It's an awl. My husband's behind the camera there. Awl. And anyway, it's not an owl. It doesn't go hoot hoot. It's an awl. And the tweezers, they are their main tools for this paper filigree. Okay. Then, it also, the only instructions, like I showed in the first video, is this sheet of paper that has a picture of the design, which it's a heart with flowers, and it has this little legend on the bottom with the colors that are numbered. Well, these numbers don't correspond to anything. So it really didn't help, and the colors aren't true to what they are, what the little strips of paper are, if you understand what I'm saying. There was nothing to match up the color. So I basically had to create my own color scheme on the filigree.
Can you see it?
Huh? My husband's talking to me back there, and I'm trying to answer him.
Hold up the painting so you can see the colors.
Well, I didn't want to hold up the painting yet.
Okay, all
right. I don't want to hold it up.
All right.
We're going to have to cut that out.
I don't want to argue with you.
Okay, so it's not... I should have started doing this video when I first started the project, but I really didn't think about it. So a lot of my struggles you really can't see. I've tried to narrate some of what I was doing, and then I have some on fast forward. So we'll see how it turns out, and then I'll show you the picture at the end of the video, okay? So let's get this going.
Okay, I'm going to try and actually one here for you. If I can get the camera to cooperate with me and not fall over. Let's see. So I'm going to take it in with my tweezers like this. I got a strip of paper here, and I'll cut it off once I get it lined up. Okay, so I'm going to try to get it in here as close as I can. This is just to measure it. Now on short ones like this, I can cut it right off at the top here where it ends, but the long ones I have to glue in as I go. Okay, so I pretty much got that, and if it's not even with the ends of the lines, it's okay, because you're going to have other strips going across and you don't want it to take up the room in there. So I've got my glue bottle here, and I'm gonna, I don't know if you could see that, I'm just gonna stick it in the cut there, and I'm going to squeeze, and I'm just going to run this through to the end of the hole. Okay, Get some more glue in there. And I have my paper towel here to wipe off the end. All right. I'm going to take my tweezers again. And I'm going to... Okay, pair with me here. It's hard to do this while I'm doing it on camera. I'm going to slide it into the ridge and get this piece in here as close. Get it right in there. See, and this is the tough. There we go. I feel it. I see it going in there. There we go. All right. Did you see that? How that went in there? I think my hand was probably in the way. There. No, it's still not quite in the ledge there. Okay. Then I take my little, what they call awl, and I kind of scrape it in here to get that extra glue out. Scrape it on the other side, get all that extra glue out here. Let me see if I can move the camera around for you. And I don't know if you could see that glue strip in there, but I'm going to take that. And then this also helps make sure you get the edges in there, because you can scrape on the side here and just go run along, and it'll make sure that, don't forget to wipe your stuff off with the wet paper towel. So anyway, that is in there like so. Can you see that? That was one. Now I like to do these little lines in the flowers before I get the long strips on, because then I know how much room I need to leave for the long strip to go through, and you'll see what I mean. Okay, so I'm going to move the camera now. We're going to go over this way. All right, and I'm going to do this one right here. Okay, I've never actually done this kind of stuff on camera before, so you're going to have to kind of bear with me. All right, let's see. I'm going to measure that in here. I'm going to measure it with my... Okay, so we're going to run it in there. You can see how it's fitting in the line there. Okay, so I'm going to run that in there. I'm going to try to get this in. Like I said, it's challenging. Okay, so there's the end there. And I'm going to clip this right there. All right. I'm going to pull it out and cut it. All right. All right. Here we go again. Okay, I'm going to get my glue. And I'm going to run it in there. Like so, so you can see that running in there. All right. Now, if it looks like it's too much sticking out, then I just take a wet paper towel and wipe it off. And then I can clean it afterwards. Okay, let's get this in here. All right. So we run it into the line here. I'm going to try to get it in the groove. There we go. And kind of follow it with my finger here. And it's almost like you kind of feel it when it drops in. There. Hold it there for a second. Okay, so it was a little bit extra long, but I'll just use this point. And here we go. I'm going to run this. And you want to, these little cross lines here where you're going to run a whole line, you want to make sure that those are free of the glue, like I just pulled out here. Free of the glue, okay. And this one come out just a little bit, so I'm going to stick it back in there. There we go. There's up to a point. Sometimes if you try to re-glue these in, the paper gets too mushy and you have to use a different kind. So right here,
Am I showing you right? This one, yeah, right here. I'm going to take on the outside here, and I'm just going to run my cowl. So there's some extra glue there that I'm wiping off. But you'll know because that it's in there because it'll become stiff right away. All right? You see that's going to be stiff right away. So I'm just going to make sure that everything is in there right, and we're just going to do that. Let's see. Okay. Now I might have to, I think what I'm going to have to do is take a little bit of a snip right at the end here. I don't want it to run into this line right here because that's where my cross paper is going to go. And if this is sticking out just that much, then it's better to be too short in the line there than too long. Okay, so that's perfect right there. See? There we go. So that's how it's done. I'll do one more here, and then we're going to kind of do a time lapse, a fast forward on this, and I'll do a couple extra ones for you. Okay, so I'm going to take this piece right here. Oop, get it under my wire of my camera. All right, I'm going to measure this in here. Move this a little bit back. There we go. And I hope you don't have too much of a shadow. But as you see, I'm going to run it in here. I better use my little tweezers here. I'm going to run it in here. There we go. I'm going to try to run it in the paper here so that we can get it measured. Okay, so I think it's in the groove. Gonna snip it right there. Okay, now it moved a little, so let's see, make sure it's gonna go in there. It's a little bit too long, so I'm gonna take this paper and I'm just gonna snip it off a little bit at the end there. Just snip it off. Okay, I'm sorry, I can't get the camera up to what I'm doing, so I'm going to try and do this again. I'm going to put it in there. Get it in the paper there. I still may have to snip it off a little bit. One little time, I'm going to snip it off. Sorry, you can't see what I'm doing. I just can't move the camera around. It's just me. Maybe I'll have my husband help me next time. Okay, now that's going to go in. And like I said, it's okay if it's a little too short. All right. So I'm going to get my... all right, so I just lost my yellow piece of paper that I was... Oh, there it is. I found it. Okay, so that's the paper I'm going to put in there. Okay, so I should be... if you can remember, you know, put the little glue thing back each time you're done because that prevents it. And if it does get clogged up in the tip here, then I just use this little, the owl, and I just stick it in there in the hole. Let's see if I see anything. Now, I think it's pretty clear. Okay, here we go. I'm going to... run the glue in there. Squeeze, 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 squeeze. There we go. Yeah, a little bit more. All right. Or, you know, to clean up some extra glue before you start, you can just run this through there, like so. Wipe it off. There. The glue should remain in there. All right. I'm going to take my tweezers now. And I'm going to... set that in there, and that one's going to go in perfect. Look at that. Look at that. Run it up to the end so there's a little space there. Okay. Take my little cowl, and I'm going to try to get the glue out of that end so my other paper will go through. So here I am. I'm going to run this across, make sure everything's in the line and all the glue's off. Gonna do the same thing for this side, and it all looks like it's perfectly in. Okay. How about that? It's all in there, and that's how you do it. So in these areas here where it's a little curlier, those are all my nemesis. Those a little bit harder for me to do. And anyway, so we're going to do this and fast forward and let you see me do a couple of these things and see how it looks, okay? So before we go to the fast motion part of this video, I decided I'd do a long piece and show you how I work on those. On the longer pieces, instead of measuring it out with my hand, I'm going to actually glue the piece and follow it as I go, and then I'll show you how I cut it off. So I'm going to run the glue. Going to run my glue in there. Nope, I gotta get my glasses on here. Hold on. Get some. There we go. Now I can see. All right. So now I'm going to get this glue in there, and I'm just gonna run it. And sometimes it's so nice when it decides to run in and not get all over the place. I'm gonna take just that little bit off there. Okay, and like that a little bit. Okay, so here we go. I'm going to get my tweezers. And we're going to put this in here like so. There we go. Now on these, when it's resting against another paper, it's okay to, I just kind of push it in there and let it curve around the other paper. I don't know if you can see what I'm talking about. But anyway, we're going to run it into the line here. Now you can always feel when it goes in. There, we're going to run that. I'm going to run that. And I can feel it dropping in, but we'll make sure. All right, so I'm going to stop it right there. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to make a little pinprick there. And that's where I'm going to cut it at. And we'll see if I can, if you can see what I'm doing here. Yep. Snip that off and put that right in the hole. There we go. All right, that one was easy one to do. Boy, I like it when they're like that. And I'm just going to clean off the extra glue. And then I'm going to run this. Make sure it's in the slot. There we go. I'm going to take a little bit of this glue out of that spot so it won't interfere with the piece I'm going to run up. Now, what I'm noticing is, I mess up. Being this is my first one, I mess up. I probably should have ran it all the way up through here. Okay, so I'm going to take the piece I cut off. Hey, like I said, don't take this as a tutorial. You'll never do it right. All right, so I'm going to run it along in the back there. And let's see. I'm going to kind of poke this here. Give my starting point. This thing is challenging. Oh my goodness, it is challenging. Now to sit there and find my hole where I poked. And I'm going to cut that where I poked it. All right, so now I'm going to put the glue in. And I'm going to run it a little past where it should go. All right. So let's see here. Is it this one? All right. Let's see. Get this in there. And I'll show you how I remedy this stuff. All right. So there it goes. It's run past there. I can feel it. Okay. It's in the hole. Now, see, I've been piecing it together like this when I do my mistakes. But if you hold it away from the yourself, you know, like you do on a diamond painting, you never, and then I'm going to just put a little bit of glue right there. And I'm going to squish this together right here. There we go. And you never know. That's how you fix it. All right. And that'll be in there. All righty. And you can tell because it'll get stiff when you touch it. So that's how I do the long one. Really, it should have went all the way, but that's how I do the long ones. I go ahead and glue them in there first and then cut them off because they're just too short, too long to try to measure out, especially if there's a, I'm going to put some glue in here a little bit and put that together. Yeah, especially if, I don't know, let's see if I can glue that one together there. So that, I guess that's, so now you see how do you remedy a mistake. And, just make sure that's in there. Okay, everything's in. And I put some glue here. I don't know if it's going to stick. Let's see if it'll stick there. Yeah, so now it's against there and you'll never even be able to, you'll never be able to tell. It's a little bit taller, didn't quite go in. Anyway, there you go. So on with the fast forwarding. So we'll do a little time lapse just so you can see me get some of it done, and then we'll continue on. Okay, see you in a bit. This piece in here. Okay, these are the mistakes that I'm going through. I could not get the curve to go into this point here. I don't know if you can see that little point there. I could not get the curve or the point to go, so I had to do it in two sections. So this is my second section to try to get around this little area here. Now I'm only trying to measure it right now. So I've decided that a time lapse video is not going to happen. So I'm just working this with my hands to kind of show you all the different problems that go into doing this craft. I guess you really have to be an expert. So I just want you guys to know that, you know, if you're trying this for the first time, it's not going to happen perfect. There's going to be lots of different mistakes. And shortcomings, you're going to, you know, have to repair. Trying to get this in there. All right, so now I'm trying to get this in the curve. Okay, so I'm going to try to bend this in there. Sometimes these little curves are just unforgiving. I know, you have to have a lot of patience, believe me. All right, that end went in, I think. And then I bend, and then I put my arm and I'm bending the other part of my. And that's the one thing I don't understand, is how you do this without running into all the other sections. There. I think okay, it's stiff. It's in there. All right. So there you go. There's my little piece I did. So I had to break it, do this section first, this little piece, and then I cut a piece and put this section in here. Okay. So just showing you, it is not that easy to do. You have to have a lot of patience. So I'm not sure what, I think from now on, I'm going to just do snapshots of this. And maybe as I get to some other little lines here, I'll continue on. So just bear with me and watch through the video and see what goes on, and see what happens. Wish me luck. Okay, if you're starting off with a long piece of paper and you just have a little bit here to do, I cut off the extra strip so I can work with it better. And then I measure my piece in here. And then I snipped it off right at the end there. And now I have a piece here that I can fit in. Okay? So now I'm going to put my glue in, and like I said, be careful not to overflow it. You just need to press it just a little bit, so it doesn't even show. And don't forget to wipe your tip off. Don't forget to wipe your tip off and put your cover back on. Okay. All right. So now I'm going to take my, okay. So here we go. Here's my strip. Okay. So now I'm going to take this and I'm going to put that in there. Let me get the camera straight here. Okay. So here I go. And I've already got it in my shape. I'm getting a little bitter as I go on this, so that's why I wanted to do another little sample here. Just there. And don't press too hard on this, because that little edge, those little ridges aren't very deep. And that's why the glue pops up really fast if you squeeze too hard. Now that's going to run into this little section here. So I'm just going to snip this, and I'm not really good at making the straight lines when I'm snipping, but I'm just going to snip a little bit. And then I'm going to pull this little piece out here. And then, as you see, it leaves my little channel here free for the piece that's going to go around here. Okay? So I just wanted to show you that I'm getting better at it as I go. A lot of stuff I was doing after shooting some of the other scenes or the other frames that I've been learning as I go. So I'm going to continue, and we'll see how it goes. All right, I'll be back. Okay, another way to know that you're getting into the grooves that you're supposed to all the way is just to lightly tap your hand, feel across, and they should all the edges should be even with each other. Okay, so far, there may be a couple from when I first started that aren't quite in there, but most of them are pretty even. Now, if you come to a point like, I'll show you right here. Right here. Let me get that in there. Here, let me get a close-up of that. Get a better close-up. Okay, so right here, I felt that this was a little bit higher. And then I noticed that I didn't quite have it in the groove there. So let me get a little, can I get a little closer? Oh, let's see. There. So what I did, I noticed it wasn't quite in the edge of that groove. So what I did is I just squeezed my bottle a little bit, got a little bit of glue on the tip of my pen. Or this L right there on the tip, and I just put a dot down in there in that line, and I moved this over and I stuck it in there, and I just held it a little bit, and now it's even. Yeah, so there's corrections that you could do, but everything feels pretty good. You'll notice how, I'll move this back out. You notice how these things are all kind of curly. I don't know if I mentioned that before, but this was the first row I started right here. And you see how bent they are? And if you go along, you'll probably see other places that, you know, I just didn't quite get them in there that are kind of, and then from, not trying to touch
the stuff while I'm doing other mine, see how, you know, I've hit like the sides here with my hand while I'm reaching across. Well, I'm getting used to not doing that. I have to hold, I'm not leaning on the board. I'm holding my hand up on the board while I'm doing this to keep my hands from ripping across. Okay, so that's another little tip or a little thing I've learned. Okay, all right, we'll continue on. Okay, I'm gonna start on this one right here. You see it going along? And I'm trying to fit it right, not getting the camera, right where that curve is, right here. So I need to make a little bend right in there. Okay, so I'm going to take this and I'm going to make a little bend right there. All right, so now let me match. This is before I get ready to glue it. I'm going to try to match it up. There we go. And that's going to go in here. And then we've got another little curve right there. And that's going to end here. So I'm going to cut just a little bit off. I'm going to probably be too long. And I don't want all the extra paper on it right now. Oh, it's been a challenge doing this video, I tell you. This is the first like showing anybody what I'm doing, so it's kind of a little forgets here and go, oh, I forgot that, and I'll just show you. So now I'm going to try and make sure. Okay, and get that in there, and I'm going to follow it around, and I'm going to get that in there, and I'm going to follow it around there, and follow it around there, and I pretty much got it in the groove. Okay, so here we go. We are going to glue this. All right, so I'm going to glue. Now remember, don't squeeze really hard because you don't want to bubble up. And I'm going to, because the glue is coming out. I'm going to try to do this blue flower here. This is computer printout that we made, which still helps me a little bit with knowing what color, since it never came with an instruction book. Anyway, I'm going to do these blue flowers right now. So it's dark and light, dark and light, okay? Whoops, did you see that? Yeah. Okay. So this is going to be tight because of the circle around there. Thank you.
get ready for the next one. Here's the final product. And as you can see, you can't see any of my flub ups or my corrections. It's just like diamond painting. Once you step away from it, it looks perfect. So, hey, you guys try it out, okay? Thank you for watching.